morning, and welcome to worship this first Sunday in Advent. Our Advent preparation this year will be a little bit different. We are continuing with our service both online and in person. The bishop and health officials do recommend worshiping virtually at home. We will continue as we have been with the request. If you have been in a high-risk situation, such as restaurants, bars, or social gatherings, outside of the people with whom you live, that you worship with us from home for 10 to 14 days after possible exposure, or call the pastor with your concerns and he will work out a solution. Since there is a large number of people worshiping with us from home, we are continuing to the service with singing and spoken response. For those of you worshiping in person, please worship in silence or keep your mask properly in place at all times and observe good physical distance of 6 feet or more. While mass physical distancing and hand cleansing are required on church grounds, we cannot guarantee you will not be infected by coronavirus 19, as it is a highly infectious disease. We cannot promise your safety from transmission of the virus on church grounds. Our study in Proverbs continue Wednesday at 5 on Facebook Live, and then it is posted. I am available for visits via the phone. You may send your requests or prayer requests by email or by calling. Most of our hymns and psalms are from the 1989 United Methodist Hymnal. Regular attenders should receive a service folder by email. If you would like to receive a folder, please contact the church and give us your email. Hear these centering words. I will give thanks to you, Lord, with all my heart. I will tell of all your wonderful deeds. Let us join together in singing a hymn of thankfulness to God for all he has given. Hymn number 694, Come All Ye Faithful People Come.
Thank you.
Ever-loving God, we gather together in your presence to thank you for the bounty of the world you created. This year has seen many tragedies throughout the world. It has also seen many blessings. We thank you for our country, our plentiful food supply, clothing to cover us, shelter to protect us from the elements, our scientists and medical professionals that are giving so much of themselves to us, the people. As we now turn aside from our work and our fears to focus on the ultimate blessing, the gift of Christ to the world, let us remember it is through your grace and your mercy that we are saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, O Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen. Of this life. Heal all brokenness. Shape all lives with your loving hands that we might reflect your love. Amen. Hear these words of assurance. We are the people of God, forgiven, loved, and free. Let us silently confess our sins in the meditation while the Advent candle is lit.
may always be ready to welcome him.
First reading this morning is taken from Isaiah chapter 64, verse 1 through 9. Oh, that you may rend the heavens and come down, that the mountains should tremble before you, as when fire set twigs ablaze and cause water to boil. Come down. For when you did awesome things that we did not expect, you came down and the mountains trembled before you. Since ancient times, no one has heard, no ears have perceived, no eye has seen any God beside you. You acted on behalf of those who waited for him. You come to the help of those who gladly do right, who remember your ways. But when we continue to sin against them, you are angry. How then can we be saved? All of us have become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous acts are like filthy rags. We are all shriveled up like a leaf, and like the wind, our sins swept us away. No one called on your name or strive to lay hold of you. For you have hidden your face from us, and you have given us over to our sins. Yet you, Lord, are our Father. We are the clay, you are the potter. We are all the works of your hand. Do not be angry beyond measure, Lord. Do not remember our sins forever. Oh, look on us, we pray, for we are all your people. Our setting for Psalm today is Psalm 80, verse 1 through 7. O Shepherd of Israel, you led Joseph like a flock. You are enthroned upon the cherubim, shine forth. Stir up your might and come to save us. Let your face shine on us, that we may be saved.
Restore us, O God.
O Lord of hosts, do not be angry with your people.
Restore us, O Lord.
Let your face shine that we may be saved. Our second reading today is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 3 through 9. Grace and peace to you from God, our Father, and from the Lord Jesus Christ. I always thank my God for you because of his grace given to you in Jesus Christ. For in him you have been enriched in every way, with all kinds of speech and with all knowledge. God thus confirming our testimony about Christ among you. Therefore you do not lack any spiritual gift, as you eagerly await for our Lord Jesus Christ to be revealed. He will also keep you firm to the end, so that you will be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. Who has called you into fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord? Please join us as we sing hymn number 202, People Look East. In those days, following that distress, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light. The stars will fall from the sky, and the heavenly bodies will be shaken. At that time, people will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. And he will send his angels and gathers his elect from the four winds. The fig tree. As soon as its twigs get tender and its leaves comes out, you know that summer is near. Even so, when you see these things happening, you know that it is near, right at the door. Truly I tell you, this generation will certainly not pass away until all these things has happened. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. Be on guard, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going away. He leaves his house and puts his servants in charge, each with their assigned tasks, and tell the one at the door to keep watch. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know when the owner of the house will come back, whether in the evening or at midnight, or when the rooster crows, or at dawn. If he comes suddenly, Do not let him find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to everyone, watch. The word of the Lord. Today is the first day of Advent. It is the season that we prepare for the first coming of our Lord. And just as the people did not realize that the Lord was coming in those days, the Lord will return one day. And the scripture we just read in Mark talked about, in those days following the distress, the Son of Man will return with his angels. And we do not know when. But as we celebrate Advent, we are being mindful that Christ has come. He came as a babe, and we are preparing for that time, that we are a people of hope. Even now, we are in distress. Things are not normal. I don't know about you, but I've been tired of COVID now for quite a few months. And the news is that it's not going to be over for what? Quite a few more months. Best case scenario we have is that the vaccine may come out sometime later this month, and it will go to healthcare workers and then to elderly, and they might make 20 million vaccine. And that sounds like a lot, doesn't it? But 20 million compared to 320 people living in our country is a drop in the bucket. And so we are in distress. And we as the people of God should never give up hope in the midst of the distress. For we are a people of hope. During the days of Isaiah, and that's the scripture passage for today, we see that Isaiah and the people of Israel was facing distress. Specifically, Babylon was invading and they would fall and be taken away as prisoners. And so as a people in distress, they were looking to God for answers. And the passage starts out in Isaiah 64 verse 1 through 9. Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down, and that the mountains would tremble before you, as when fire set twigs ablaze and causes water to boil. Come down and make your name known among your enemies. And what Isaiah was asking for was for God to intervene in their situation as they were in distress. And I know that we as people, not only in America, but throughout the world because of COVID and all the other things that are happening, are calling upon God that he would what? Come down. I don't know what bigger graphic image we can see than that God would rend the heavens, tear it apart, and come down. We see the same thing will happen one day when Jesus returns. The sun will be darkened and the moon will give its light no more. We put our hope in God. But when God does appear, it can be very distressing. The passage go on and said, picking up in verse 3, for when you did awesome things that we did not expect, you came down and the mountains trembled before you. Since ancient time, no one has heard, no ears have perceived, no eye has seen any God beside you. The reality we as Christians is only one God, and no one of us have heard of any other God, or have seen or perceived with our eyes or ears any other God who acts on behalf of those who wait for him. And here's the good news of hope, that God acts in our life. We may not see him with our eyes. We may not hear it with our ears. We may not perceive it. But that does not mean that God is not what? Acting. Unfortunately, we as human beings are limited and do not see God and his work. But in reality, we know that he is there. Because the scripture reminds us over and over again, picking up in verse 5 in Isaiah, "You have come to help those who gladly do what is right, who remember your ways." And the promise is that God does act and does remember us if we do what is what? Right, and remember his ways. But the scripture is quite clear. I continue reading in verse 5. "But when we continue to sin against them, you are angry. How then can we be saved?" The problem is not God. The problem is with what? With us. When we continue to sin. When we continue to sin against God's ways. Isaiah continues and points out the situation quite clearly. Verse 6. "All of us have become like ones who is unclean, and our righteous acts are like filthy rags." All of us have become like one who is unclean, and our righteous acts are like filthy rags. There's nothing that we can do to make us right with God. It continues and said, "We all shrivel up like a leaf, and like the wind, our sins sweep us away." And turned brown and shriveled up. That's the picture that we have here, that we are all sinners, guilty. And it's only because of God that we have hope. The scripture goes on and says, "No one calls on your name or strive to lay hold of you, for you have hidden your face from us and have given us over to our sin." Scripture makes it quite clear. It is not God that abandons us. It's we who have abandoned God, and it is our sin that separates us from God. But verse 8 makes it quite clear. "Yet you, Lord, are our Father." This is Old Testament, folks. Old Testament. Isaiah chapter 54, verse 8. "Yet you, Lord, are our Father." Jesus has it very right when he referred to God as what? Father. "For God is indeed our Father." And the image that Isaiah paints for us, it says, "We are the clay. You are the potter. We are all the works of your hand. Do not be angry beyond measure, Lord. Do not remember our sins forever. Oh, look on us, we pray, for we are all your people." Today, as we look forward to Christ returning, and as we look backward to his first coming as a babe, we are reminded that the Lord, our Lord, is our Father, and that we are mere clay in his hands. Yes, things happen in our lives. There are distressing things that are happening. As I mentioned, I'm tired of COVID, so are you. There are other things that are happening in our lives, family members that are affected by illness, jobs that are lost. The list goes on and on the many things that we're facing. Not being able to go out and eat together, not being able to meet as a church and socialize. But let us remember ultimately who is in charge. God is in charge. Yet you, Lord, are our Father. We are all your people. Unfortunately, we forget that God is in charge. That God is the potter. And we are mere clay in his hand. And he's the one that molds us and makes us into the vessels that he sees fit. And it's only through trials and tribulation that we can be made fit. The potter makes whatever vessel, but he has to put it in a kiln for it to dry and harden. Because without that, what happens to a clay vessel? You put anything in it and it's useless. Yes, we are faced with distress. Yes, we are faced with problems. Yes, we are faced with many things. We can always look on the bad. But as Christians, as people of hope, picking up on the second reading that we did from 1 Corinthians, it says, grace and peace to you from God, our Father, and from the Lord Jesus Christ. I always thank my God because of you. Because of his grace given to you in Jesus Christ. For in him you have been enriched in every way. We just recently passed Thanksgiving, and as a nation and as a people, we should always be thankful to our God, our Father, and our Lord Jesus Christ. Because he has surely enriched us in many ways. We are a people of hope, and we look forward not only to Christ's coming, but we also look backward with hope, knowing that he came once as a babe. The word of the Lord. At this time, we'll have special music.
Jesus conquered the grave.
Pray for the church in Myanmar and Thailand. We also continue to pray for Leah and Medwald, for Ryan and Elizabeth Smith, and for Greta Roberts. Let us go to the Lord in prayer, followed by the Lord's Prayer. Loving God, we thank you for this day. We are a people of hope. Because you, O God, are our Father. We are like clay in your hands. We ask that you mold us to the image and likeness that you want us to be. That we would be useful vessels of yours. And Lord, as we face these distressing times, like clay in a kiln, as we feel the heat and the pressure and the problems, may we be reminded that you are using that in order to make us strong. Lord, we are never happy whenever we face problems. May we continue as a people of hope during these difficult times, realizing that you are still God. You still sit on your throne, and that we need not fear. Our responsibility is to be watching and waiting, to be ready to do the good things that you have chosen us to do the right things. Lord, we pray for our church. We ask that you be also with the church in Myanmar and Thailand. Lord, we lift up Leah. We remember Ryan and Elizabeth as they face difficulties. And we pray for Greta with her cancer. And Lord, we pray for those unspoken requests that were not voiced this day. And we join now together as your children and pray to you as our Lord and Savior taught us to say, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you. 56571. Let us join together in singing, "Come, thou long expected Jesus, born to set your people free," hymn number 196. Join now as we dismiss with our singing "Soon and Very Soon."